Hello and welcome to the Higher Music Technology Understanding Music Paper Breakdown. First of all, we're going to concentrate on questions 1, 2 and 3 from the 2019 paper. This focuses on different styles and genres. Including the different musical and technological features and faults and their corrections. So, question number 1. So, question number 1 is always the same. There's usually a part A and a part B. In this one, you're expected to identify two different terms from the list below and describe what you hear. Now, you get to hear the music twice. Now, first of all, what you want to do is identify which ones are styles and which ones are maybe musical concepts. In this case, we have reggae, world music, and jazz funk. Those are three styles of music we can identify from. That's the easy part. The harder part is to identify the two musical features within. So what we need to do is have a look at what we think the different things mean, the different concepts mean. So you've got reggae first of all, which is kind of music from Jamaica. It's got offbeats, it's laid back, you've got a relaxed performance, it includes electric guitar and so on. Maybe some organ thrown in there as well. You've got world music, which is music from Africa, India, or Latin America. You've got jazz funk, which will include ostinatos or riffs, syncopation, groove sections, prominent bass and so on. You've got ritardando, which means the music is slowing down, and the counter melody, which is a secondary melody that plays over the top of the main melody. So this question is very similar to the question we'd get in a National 5 paper, which looks like this. So you've got your column A, that's your different features, and you've got your column B, which is your kind of musical feature. Back to the higher paper. So, let's have a wee go and see how we get on.
Question 1. A. Listen to this excerpt and identify two terms from the list below which describe what you hear. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me. No, nobody else but me. Hey, hey, hey. Cupid, please hear my cry.
Here is the music for the second time.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me. Nobody else but me. Hey, hey, hey. Cupid, please hear my cry and let your arrow fly straight to my lover's heart for me.
So, that was your first one. The answer was obviously reggae. Was the style of music, and for your musical feature, the answer was counter melody. That was a little string section you heard at the end there. So, for part B, you're listening to the same piece of music and you're describing two music features present. Now, it's important not to get confused with the difference between music features and technology features, and we'll discuss that in a later question. However, this question should be an absolute scoosh. You shouldn't even need to listen to the music for a third time to be able to get it, because hopefully you've been studying your styles and genres lesson. So for reggae, you've got beats 2 and 4 emphasised, you've got a repeated riff pattern, offbeat chords and so on, relaxed performance, syncopated bass line. Any of these would be an accepted answer. So let's have a listen.
B. Listen to the excerpt again. Describe two music features present which are typical of the genre style.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me. No, nobody else but me. Hey, hey, hey. Cupid, please hear my cry.
So, obviously with the answers on the screen, that shouldn't have been too difficult. So I put down offbeat chords and expressive and soulful vocals. Two very acceptable answers, but any of the ones you can see would have been would have got you the 2 marks. So, moving on to question 2. In this question, you have to listen and identify the genre. Often you'll be asked to identify two music features or two technology features. In this case, you have to identify the genre, one music feature and one technology feature. So just so that you understand the difference between the two, music features can include anything from ostinatos, syncopation, the different instruments that are being used, different melodic features, anything that's to do with the actual music itself, musical concepts that are unique to that particular style and genre. For instance, if it was reggae, you could have said that the emphasis was on the two and beats 2 and 4 in the bar. That would have been a good music feature to put down. For technology features, you have to identify technology or features that are, or technological features that are common to the genre. Things like the different recording techniques, the type of microphones used perhaps, or the maybe the lack of post-production. Something like punk, for instance, doesn't use a lot of post-production. That would be a technology feature. The different effects that are used, like for instance distortion and guitars if it's rock music, the use of synthesizers, anything like that can be considered a technology feature. So let's have a listen.
Question 2. A. Listen to this excerpt and identify the genre. Give two reasons for your answer, one referring to a music feature and the other to a technology feature. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time. Here is the music for the second time. We'll be right back.
So hopefully that wasn't too difficult for you. The genre, of course, was jazz funk. The music feature I selected was, I kept it nice and simple, syncopation. And the technological feature I used was wah-wah, which was on the guitar, that kind of wah-wah effect on the guitar. There was loads of different things you could have put in there. For instance, there was ostinatos and riffs, lots of repetition in there as well. Extended groove sections, complex bass lines. You could have said about jazz instrumentation with electric instruments, obviously electric guitar, there was an organ, synthesizer in there, and the bass was heavily featured throughout. Technological features, it was kind of live sounding recording with minimal post-production, so it wasn't a lot of effects and things added after the piece was recorded. Again, that's a kind of common feature in jazz funk, often recorded live. Use of modulation effects on the organ and the different synthesizers that were there. Again, you could have said the use of synthesizer and the use of the organ or Hammond organ, and of course wah-wah. All of these were accepted answers and would have gotten you the 3 marks. So moving on, we've got part B. This time you have to identify one of 4 different musical concepts. So again, this just takes revision. However, a way to make sure you get the right answer is, there's 2 ways. Just know what these concepts are, first and foremost. And if you're not too sure of one or not too sure of a couple of them, then using the process of elimination, and we'll have a look at that once we've heard the example. First of all, you've got modulation, which is a change of key. Cross rhythms, if 2 contrasting rhythms going against each other, it's usually 3 against 2, so triplets against quavers, that type of thing. You've got an inverted pedal, which is a long, high, sustained or repeated note while the music underneath changes. And then you've got portamento. This is a smooth sort of gliding transition between 2 different notes. So it's like it's not a glissando, because it's only between 2 notes, often found in synthesizers and things like that. So, let's do this question.
E. Listen to this excerpt and identify one term from the list below which describes what you hear. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time.
Killing. First you make a stone of your heart, and if you find that your hands are still willing, then you can turn a murder into art. There really isn't any need for bloodshed, just do it with a little more finesse. If you can slip a tablet to someone's coffee, an inner voice, an awful lot of mess.
Here is the music for the second time.
Once that you've decided on a killing, first you make a stone of your heart, and if you find that your hands are still willing, then you can turn a murder into art. There really isn't any need for bloodshed, just do it with a little more finesse. Can slip a tablet into someone's coffee, an inner voice, an awful lot of mess.
So again, I hope that wasn't too difficult for you. Easiest way to do that one, if you weren't too sure it was a difficult one, is think about the concepts that you do know. So the easy ones: modulation, was there a change of key? No. Portamento. Was there a synthesizer or anything that could do a portamento? It started off with drums, then you've got the voice, and then a guitar. There definitely wasn't portamento. Inverted pedal, a long, high, sustained note, absolutely not, which left you, if you weren't sure, with the cross rhythms. The cross rhythms itself was against the voice and, of course, the guitar and the drum kit, which the drum kit was playing 3-4 all the way through. The voice came in with a kind of 6-8 or 9-8 feeling, so each beat's broken up into three. So you've got that 3-2 feeling all the way through. A little indicator, again, if you're not sure how to identify it, if it feels like the two instruments don't fit rhythmically, then cross rhythms is probably going to be the answer there. So moving on to question three. In this question, you're going to hear two different recordings of the same piece of music. This already tells you it's a vocal recording, and you have to identify the recording fault. So your faults question, you can be asked from a recording fault, could be a technical fault, it could be an editing fault, a MIDI fault, no matter what it is, have a look at what it's actually asking you, because that limits down your potential options for an answer. So looking at the different faults, what they could be. So for instance, if it's a recording fault, it could be that the microphone's too close, or the gain's too high. So you might have distortion if the voice is going too loud. If there's no pop shield, so you'll get popping and blasting, that kind of thing. So poor microphone placement or technique, or the microphone's too far away, or it's off to the side, something like that. You could also maybe argue in some cases that the wrong microphone has been used. So for instance, if you've got a condenser microphone or poor microphone technique, for instance, if the vocalist comes away from the mic, gets quiet and then gets loud again, you could maybe say that, and that actually they maybe should be using a condenser mic, something like that. Corrections, right, so there's a couple of things. I mean, the recording fault question is quite an easy one to answer. It's very obvious. You could change the microphone position, you can get closer or further away. You could use a pop shield if there's popping and blasting. You could move the mic off its axis, so change its direction to suit the polar pattern, or you could reduce or increase the gain. Let's have a listen.
Question 3. In this question, you will hear two recordings. For each one, you must identify the fault in the recording and describe in detail how to correct it. A. Listen to this excerpt of a vocal recording. Identify the recording fault and describe in detail how to correct it. You will hear this excerpt twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time.
Encouraging positive behaviour is the best way to improve attitude. People who ignore poor performance and bring a positive attitude to a situation should quickly see behaviour improve. The best bit of advice which can be given is to believe that people genuinely want to be good and that bad behaviour is taught by others, be it their colleagues, friends, peers, or even parents. The biggest issue when promoting positive behaviour is to address not just the challenging attitude, but to improve and change the behaviours of the people who surround the issue. Every positive behaviour demonstrated should be acknowledged and, if appropriate, rewarded. A plan should also be brought into play which identifies each challenge, then has a clear reaction which should be both controlled, controllable, and seek to encourage a positive response. Encouraging positive behaviour is easy to do and can make a remarkable difference.
Here is the excerpt for the second time.
Encouraging positive behaviour is the best way to improve attitude. People who ignore poor performance and bring a positive attitude to a situation should quickly see behaviour improve. The best bit of advice which can be given is to believe that people genuinely want to be good and that bad behaviour is taught by others, be it their colleagues, friends, peers, or even parents. The biggest issue when promoting positive behaviour is to address not just the challenging attitude, but to improve and change the behaviours of the people who surround the issue. Every positive behaviour demonstrated should be acknowledged and, if appropriate, rewarded. A plan should also be brought into play which identifies each challenge, then has a clear reaction which should be both controlled, controllable, and seek to encourage a positive response. Encouraging positive behaviour is easy to do and can make a remarkable difference.
You now have 1 minute to complete your answer.
we're not going to need 1 minute. So I'm hoping that it was fairly obvious, especially after doing all your Foley projects, that there was definitely popping and blasting throughout that mix. Anything with a Q or an H or a P, the air when he was speaking is hitting up against that microphone. The easiest solution to that would be to use a pop shield. You would have also got a mark if you said the microphone technique or the placement was poor. A correction could have been adjusting the mic position, moving the mic off its axis, and of course what I said was using a pop shield. That's the easiest way to fix that issue. So, moving on to part B. This time we're going to listen to a MIDI drum track and we've got to identify the fault. So again, just like when it says a recording fault, there are specific faults and corrections related to MIDI. So, obvious one is that you've plugged in your keyboard and you've played along and you're just simply out of time. The computer's not done it correctly. Therefore, you're going to need to fix that. We'll talk about that correction in a moment. You've used the wrong pitch. So for instance, if you're playing on strings but you've gone way up to the top end of the keyboard and it sounds wrong, or you've added a trumpet and it just sounds ridiculously high, that could be a fault. Control's not used, so for instance you might have had a reverb added and it's a really dry sound, or vice versa, or there's not enough attack. So for instance, often when you're using strings, but you press the key, the strings won't start for a little bit later and you need to adjust the attack. It could be anything like that. The corrections. So to fix out of time, you would use quantization. This will fix the timing issues. What this does is it places the notes where the computer thinks it should be, based on how you program your quantization. You could just re-record the whole track and do it again and just play it in time, which would be an obvious solution. Or you can reprogram the track with quantization. Perhaps there is quantization on the track, maybe it's just too strict, so it's put the beats in the wrong place, or it's too wide, so you've maybe set it to semi-quavers or something like that, therefore there's more room for the computer to put it in the wrong place. So, let's have a little look and see what the answer is.
B. Listen to this excerpt and identify the fault in the MIDI drum track, and describe in detail how to correct it. You will hear this excerpt twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time. Here is the excerpt for the second time.
Okay, so to me, at least, the problem is fairly obvious, that the drums are out of time. Simple as that. People tie themselves knots around these questions because they think maybe the quantization's not right or the thing's not strict. No, you just need to say that the drums are out of time. For the correction, you want to quantize the drum track. Like I said before, quantizing fixes all your problems and it puts it sets the correct value for all the notes in the right place. So that was it. That is our whistle stop tour of questions 1, 2 and 3. I hope that was helpful. What I would do now if I was you is have a look at questions 1, 2 and 3 in a past paper and let's see if you can get them correct.